Don't paint, Graeme.
Choice that they are both about to make. I did ask them, what is love? Graeme came out with the great answer of, it's a chemical reaction in the brain. And it is. But we just can't explain why or what that is. Rebekka suggests that to love someone is to help someone else. Think of someone before you think of yourself, to be committed, and choosing only one person to love. The Greeks outdo the English language quite a bit, because we all only have one word in our English language for love. But the Greeks perhaps have it better than us, And they have four main words for love. And the first one is storge, which is a type of feeling you could have towards a commanding officer, or maybe a teacher, or someone you actually look up to. And then they also have philia, which is the feelings that a parent can have to a child to a parent. Brothers and sisters have this type of love as well. And then there's eros, which is simply broken down to physical affection. Yes, it means sex. Okay? And then they have one that they call agape love, which means self-sacrificing, putting the other person first. It even says that they're willing to lay down their life for that person that they choose to love. So, Becca and Graeme, you have agape love for one another. Do you love each other that you're willing to lay down your life for each other? It has been written that no greater love is shown than when a person is willing to lay down his or her life for another. I want to add to this idea, it's very admirable that you're willing to lay down your life, but are you willing to live for your spouse, to be the best person that Rebekka can be, to be the best person that Graeme can be. Love each other enough to live for each other. To be the very best that you can be each and every day. And that is the harder part than actually laying down the life. Becca, Graeme deserves your best. Graeme Rebekka deserves your best. She's the best individual that you can be. As each individual does strive to do their individual best, you will need to support one another in their dreams and their hopes, even if they seem silly, ridiculous, and way out there. It's hard to reach a dream on your own, and that is why you are giving your lives to one another. I wish I could say that your life together will be easy and there will not be any issues, but everybody else knows the truth. There will be very hard days. Unfortunately, you will end up hurting one another. There will be hardships that you will have to face, and you will choose to face them together or try to battle them on your own. And sometimes there will be days of anger, that you will be upset. When those days come, I encourage you both to be quick to forgive. Hold no record of wrong. Do not hold a grudge. You will always be the first to say I'm sorry. I have wasted many hours of my life being upset with my wife Lisa, and realized that I'll never get those hours. Thank you. Finishes high school, just working at Timmy, so parents, we all encourage Becca to move out west to some weird place called Moose Jaw, hang out with her older sister Cassie. She's never been out of Ontario. Here's a summer to do whatever before you decide what you might do next. Knowing Rebekka, we had to beg her, bribe her, even threaten her to go. And we all thought she'd be back by the end of summer. And that's been 6 years, and she's still not come back to Ontario. And so I had to move out here. But and I remember the first call. Becca, why are you not coming back? What's going on? Called down, says, Dad, I've met somebody. Okay, what does that mean? Oh, Dad, you would really like this guy. He's really nice. Okay. He does nice things for me. He's good with his hands. And I said, Becca. No, Dad. He's good fixing cars. Oh, okay. And he's also good with computer. That day, I heard something different in Rebekka's voice that I've never heard before. And I can't explain it. But I knew, I think for the first time in her life, she was falling in love. She didn't say those words, and I didn't dare out of it because I knew she'd never come back to her dad. But there definitely was something different in her voice that phone call. And I'm so happy and so excited for you. Okay. And what that brings? Graeme, please repeat after me. I, Graeme, give you, Rebekka, this ring.
I, Graeme, give you, Rebekka, this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment and love.
As a symbol of my commitment and love.
The physical evidence that I will honor you and respect you.
The physical evidence that I will honor you and respect you.
This ring is to remind you and all others that I choose you, Rebekka, to be my wife for the rest of my life. I, Rebekka, give you, Graeme, this ring.
I, Rebekka, give you, Graeme, this ring.
As a symbol of my commitment and love.
As a symbol of my commitment.
The physical evidence that I will always honor you and respect you.
The physical evidence
that
I will always honor you and respect you.
This ring is to remind you and all others.
This ring is to remind you.
She is my daughter. Graeme,
No, I almost lost it.
It's not too bad, they're all smiling so far.
Front cover of wedding magazine.
Everyone look at the iPad.
High five. High five.
Oh,
You guys look so good!
Golf, but miss the ball.